Every now and then, we hear and read about critical security issues in the software that we use in our day-to-day lives. These security holes are caused by tiny bugs in the code and can lead to devastating results. People can hack into your computer, steal your information, or even hold it hostage. Luckily though, we can fix these issues with a software update. But on the 1st of June 2017, researchers working for Google's Project Zero found two major security flaws in modern processors. You know, the brains of your computer, phone, tablet, TV, and whatnot. These flaws allow any program to read sensitive information from memory. Yikes. The bugs are called Meltdown and Spectre, and because they are so sensitive, Google decided to keep it a secret until vendors had come up with workarounds that would protect us. So let's take a look at how these bugs work, but before we can do that, let's quickly go over some basic concepts. As you know, a CPU is the brain of all our devices. A processor is responsible for executing all the instructions that our operating system and our programs give it. How fast the processor is depends on its clock speed. The higher this is, the more work your processor can do per second. So for a while, chip makers were in a fight to keep increasing the clock speed. They, however, reached the ceiling when they hit the 3 to 4 GHz range. Increasing it further was impossible, so instead, chip makers had to get creative and they came up with something called speculative execution. Basically, it means that the processor will guess what the outcome of an instruction will be and execute all subsequent steps in the background. More on that later. The last thing we need to understand is memory. Our devices have two types of memory: the main system memory, also called RAM, and the cache memory in the processor. The CPU needs to constantly read and write data from the main memory. However, the main memory is way slower than the CPU. So chipmakers added a small cache on the processor itself to store the data that it's working with. Every time the processor needs something from the main memory, it copies it, stores it in its cache, and reads it from there. Okay, so now that we know the basics, we can start explaining the Meltdown bug. Our operating system stores sensitive information in the main memory of our devices. Think about your Wi-Fi key, for instance. They store this data in protected memory, and CPUs make sure that no one has access to this part of the memory except the operating system itself. So far, so good, except that they don't enforce this rule when they are speculating, and that leaves the door open for exploits. Let's assume that you visit a website that wants to steal your Wi-Fi password, which for now is safely stored in protected memory. First, the attacking website has to make sure that your CPU cache doesn't contain your actual Wi-Fi password. To do that, it reads and writes some random data to the main memory. Remember that when you access the main memory, the processor keeps a copy of this data in its own cache for faster retrieval. It also loads an image from the internet that will be used later on. So now that your CPU's cache is filled with random data, the website tries to read the first letter of your Wi-Fi password from the protected memory with code that might look like this. If your password starts with the letter S, the site reads the first pixel of the image into memory. But wait a minute, the CPU will prevent the website from accessing protected memory. But because the CPU speculates, it might have executed this code in the background and didn't tell us about it. If your Wi-Fi password indeed starts with the letter S, the CPU will execute a read pixel command while it is speculating. And when the CPU reads this pixel from the main memory, it puts a copy of it in its own cache. All the website has to do now is run a second program that times how long it takes to read that pixel. If it happens super fast, we know that the pixel was in the CPU's cache, and this could have only happened when the CPU was speculating and only if our password starts with the letter S. If it's not so fast, then the data comes from the main memory, and then we know that the password doesn't start with an S. It's clear how this technique can be extended to not only read the first character, but to read your full password from protected memory. In fact, with Meltdown, it's possible to read sensitive data at speeds of up to half a megabyte per second. Almost all Intel processors and a handful of ARM processors are susceptible to this bug. Only AMD chips are resilient because they don't speculate when protected memory is being accessed. However, this is only the tip of the iceberg. Let's move on to Spectre, a weakness that is very similar to Meltdown but affects all modern CPUs, not just the one from Intel. While Meltdown only allows programs to read protected memory, Spectre allows malicious programs to read the memory from any other program on your system. To give a concrete example, a website could use Spectre to read the contents of another browser tab, one where you might be logged into your bank account, for instance. This becomes an even bigger problem in professional situations. Public clouds like AWS, Google Cloud, and Microsoft Azure are rushing to implement safeguards against Spectre and Meltdown. If left unpatched, it would allow one customer's virtual machine to steal data from another customer's VM. Spectre is much more difficult to patch compared to Meltdown, and that's also why they named it Spectre, a ghost that will haunt us for quite some time. Now that we know how the exploits work, what can we do about them? Patching processors isn't possible because we can't change the hardware that is already shipped. Instead, we have to mitigate it with software updates. There are already patches available for Windows, macOS, and Linux, so make sure that you have the latest versions installed. Mobile devices also need to be patched. Updates for iOS are already available, and also Google has patches available for Android. However, they depend on manufacturers to make the updates available to the users. And finally, make sure that the rest of your software is up to date as well. Browsers like Firefox and Chrome are also offering patches to mitigate the risks of websites stealing your sensitive information. So that was it for this video, but don't worry, there are plenty of other videos on my channel that you can check out. And as always, thank you very much for watching.